Sure. No worries. Oh, look, I gotta go. The cavalry just turned up. Okay. Bye. Corporal, what can I do for you?
Listen, Jerry, you gotta get rid of that stuff. It's making me nervous. I'm not into drugs, and
I don't... Chill the fuck out, my friend. You're really getting on my nerves. Besides, who are you gonna get in trouble with? I'm your superior officer, and you told me you needed the money.
I do need the money.
Uh-huh. But you don't like drugs.
I don't think they're a good scene.
Me neither. But you like guns, huh? They don't give you a moral problem, I mean.
No.
Good. Because I know a guy who can sell all the guns we can get him, which is, trust me, quite a lot.
I don't know, Sergeant. This is getting heavy.
You'll make a whole pile of cash for nothing. Buy that sick brother of yours a whole lot of candy.
What do I have to do?
Nothing. Just go and pick up the money from him. He's down over by the docks.
Hey, Vic. You want some of this, huh?
Go enlist, son!
Must be Vic. Jerry told me about you.
Hey, I used to be in the service.
Yeah, listen. He said you'd have some money for me.
Sure, sure. Well, I ain't a bank. I don't have it on me. But I'll take you to it.
See, what would you do?
Look, hey man, a man's gotta live off the land, you know?
That's right.
You gotta be prepared to wrap yourself some plastic wrap together and share the warmth, man. You know, hey, two bodies pressed together, you know, it's cold, you know.
I've been having trouble with them Cholo boys. Some of them have...
What the hell is a Cholo?
Bunch of Mexican gangbangers, bad boys, trying to take over all the gun running in town.
Look, where's the money, Phil?
Yeah, well, funny thing, you see, it's like this. It's under the floorboards of my old place, but the Cholo evicted me and now I can't get to it.
I'll get to it. See you around.
I'm gonna kick your ass!
Come on, on then!
I'm a soldier, Frank!
You can't kill
Stay
me!
Calm.
Cholo kill you, good pendejo!
Show me you're the man! Oh.
Don't be an idiot!
Show. Real people, not office folk. I mean, people with necks. A couple of girls with big tits advertising the ammunition bazooka sale. I said to her, hey, you got a license to carry them 44s? Oh, she didn't get it.
Just sluts, man. You know what I mean? They're just sluts.
All right, shut up. Okay, you hear me? Just shut up, right? I ain't doing this no more. And I mean no more like never. You hear me, Bobby Ray? You hear me? You are acting hysterical.
Hell
acting
no.
Funny? And I don't mean ha-ha funny. I mean funny like
that. Yeah, yeah, man. All right. I hear you, Larry Joe. It's just...
All right, so say it.
Look, man, all right, I'm sorry I called your wife Mary Sue a whore, okay? And those two hooker sluts, I'm sorry.
Bobby just upset me. Strike on the head, line broke. Rising's about to pull into the boat. I mean, I understand that. Now, he's just letting off some steam, trying to relax. Sometimes, relaxing can be stressful. It's like when you accidentally hit a bitch in the face from out of the fuck off. You know what I'm saying? And you, be quiet, or I'll walk, and you'll be back at the truck stops and off the goddamn radio. Oh, damn, relaxing's great. And here at the boat show, it's all about relaxing.
I'll tell you, man, you know what relaxing is? Jerk it off.
Right now, on bait and switch, we got a guy I met earlier with some no serious outdoors we can do without. Welcome to Bait and Switch, Kenny Crane!
Hey guys, how y'all doing?
Hey, have a lager beer.
You bet your ass.
So, Kenny, how you enjoying the boat show?
Man, salute a veteran, asshole!
Every year, I mean, this year is just amazing. I mean, it's just full of boats upon blocks.
Yeah, it's a